Before its dangers became universally acknowledged, asbestos was a valuable commodity in the world of shipbuilding in the 20th century. Resistant to corrosion and heat, it seemed an ideal material to overcome many shipboard dangers. Over 300 asbestos-containing materials were commonly used on ships until the 1970s. Although the Navy eventually instigated an asbestos abatement program, many of these materials remained in place on existing ships. Even now in the 21st century, some asbestos-containing materials is still allowed during new ship construction if no good alternatives exist. The most common use of asbestos on board has been for insulation. Asbestos could be found in pipe covering, which insulated hot steam pipes, hot water lines, and fuel lines. The sprayed-on form of asbestos insulation became highly friable over time. Preformed pipe insulation was a safer form but still contained asbestos that could be damaged by extreme conditions. Regardless of its form, pipe insulation was frequently cut off and replaced, exposing workers and anyone in the area to asbestos dust. Another common use of asbestos was in brick and cement used on pumps, turbines, compressors, and condensers, and virtually any other equipment that generated much heat. Boilers contained asbestos brick and asbestos liners sandwiched between brick and steel layers. Asbestos was also used in exhaust systems, including connectors and manifolds. Asbestos was used in meters, capacitors, dielectric paper, instruments and instrument paneling, rods, valves, packing assemblies, insulation felts, and adhesives. Personnel exposed to asbestos during the course of their work included ship fitters, machinists, pipe fitters, pipe coverers, boilermakers, electricians, welders, riggers, and engineers.